Rishad Badiuddin, the Minister of Industry and Commerce, today accepted that only around 30% of persons have been settled in the Vilpattu area. The minister made this statement speaking to reporters while touring the area in question today.
The Vilpattu National Park is Sri Lanka's largest national park. Not only is it large in size, this national park is home to 605 different plant species and 328 animal species as it dates back to the Vijayakweni era of Sri Lanka. Since 1938, the area of the Vilpattu National Park was expanded from time to time. According to environmentalists and nature lovers, at present, around 2,500 hectares of this massive national park have been destroyed. In February 2013, upon the instructions of the Presidential Task Force, which was formed to handle the resettlement, at that time, resettlement of persons in the national park commenced.
There needs to be a procedure that is to be followed when lands are provided to the people. A list of guidelines have been presented in Articles 23A and B in the National Environment Act. This gazette clearly states that conversion of forests covering an area exceeding 1 hectare into non-forest users needs to be done after an environmental impact assessment report is carried out to determine if the land is suitable for such non-forest users. In addition, permission needs to be given only after looking into under what conditions and what boundaries will the non-forest use will be carried out.
When Minister Rishad Badiuddin visited the national park today, he noted that there is no need to be impatient over an environment report.
Simply because he is a minister and if he is using his ministerial powers in an arbitrary manner to destroy forests, there is an issue as to what the leaders of this country are doing while this act is taking place. We will resort to legal action in the future. If deforestation continues, we will gather the masses against this.
The area of the Vilpattu National Park, which has been subject to deforestation and destruction, is a northern area that comes under the purview of the Department of Wildlife Conservation. According to the Forest Conservation Ordinance, it is illegal to construct permanent or temporary settlements, roads and farmlands in such a forest area.
Around 2,000 families will be living in these villages. Of those 200 families, many have not come here to be resettled. Only 30% of that number have settled here. Another 70% is to arrive here.
News First journalist Nusha Jayath is questioned what measures will be taken to provide the required infrastructure facilities in line with increasing population numbers. President Maithripala Sirisena ordered for the immediate halt to deforestation and land clearing at the Vilpattu National Park as it destroys the balance in nature and also takes away all environmental resources that needs to be given to the future generations of Sri Lanka. However, information that came to light today at this media briefing indicates that the resettlement in this area in question is ongoing.